was a year of miracles when communism collapsed in the countries of Central and Eastern Europe. After a 40-year-long isolation behind the Iron Curtain, these captive nations finally had a chance to free themselves of Soviet dictatorship and began their transformation into free market democracies. In just a few years, they rejoined the West by becoming members of NATO and the European Union. Following the Second World War, the Soviet Union had gained total control.
From Stettin in the Baltic to Trieste in the Adriatic, an iron curtain has descended across the continent. Behind that line lie all the capitals of the ancient states of Central and Eastern Europe. Warsaw, Berlin, Prague, Vienna, Budapest, Belgrade, Bucharest, and Sofia. All these famous cities and the populations around them lie in what I must call the Soviet sphere.
For the so-called satellite nations, the 1950s was a dreadful time. Property was nationalized, members of the former middle and upper classes were arrested or deported.
East Berliners who have apartments facing the border take the long chance when they get orders to leave their homes for the interior. While an East German guard attempts to yank her back to prison, West Berliners pull her to a fire net and freedom.
In each country, a brutal secret service directed by the Soviets' local secret police built a network of informants in order to control every aspect of citizens' lives. Local prison camps were modeled on the Soviet gulag, labor, and re-education camps. Farmers were forced into cooperatives with harsh production quotas. People's wages were kept low, and food was rationed. The publications of books and journals and people's ability to travel were all tightly controlled by the communist authorities. The United States soon realized that its one-time ally, the Soviet Union, was posing a threat to the free world. In response, President Harry Truman formulated a policy of supporting countries threatened from the outside by communist forces. With the formation of the U.S. Department of Defense, the National Security Council, the Central Intelligence Agency, and the North Atlantic Treaty Organization, America entered a Cold War. The Soviet Union ruled its satellite countries, the captive nations, with an iron fist. In the biggest show of armed resistance, Hungarian students and workers joined together in October of 1956 in an attempt to reclaim their country. The Hungarian Revolution lasted for 13 days, culminating in the establishment of a free government. But on November 4th, Soviet troops returned to Hungary with overwhelming force and brutally crushed the revolution. Soviet tanks in the streets of Budapest sent a clear message to the entire world. Citizens had no choice. Despite Marxist dreams and the rhetoric of equality, the Communist Party would rule unwilling citizens. The U.S. took an active role in preventing the further spread of communist governments in Europe and elsewhere.
Today, in the world of freedom, the proudest boast is, Ich bin ein Berliner.
Crushing defeat met protesters in Czechoslovakia during the Prague Spring of 1968, when thousands of Warsaw Pact troops were sent to occupy the country after negotiations for change, supported by mass demonstrations in the heart of Prague, failed. In 1981, Polish shipyard workers in Gdansk formed Solidarity, the first non-communist party-controlled trade union in a Warsaw-packed country. Fighting for workers' rights and social change, Solidarity was outlawed in 1981 and martial law instituted after widespread protests. Changes began in 1986 when Mikhail Gorbachev came to power in the Soviet Union. In an attempt to address a collapsing social order and combat growing economic hardship in the USSR, Gorbachev started a policy of glasnost and perestroika, or openness, and economic restructuring. On the global scene, the United States began increasing its military capacity and exerting greater diplomatic pressure on the Soviet Union. On a trip to Berlin, President Ronald Reagan issued a challenge to Gorbachev.
We believe that freedom and security go together, that the advance of human liberty can only strengthen the cause of world peace. Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
Between 1988 and 1990, Poland, Hungary, Czechoslovakia, and the Baltic countries fought to transform their governments, to take back their freedom. In August 1988, Polish workers went on strike in multiple cities across the country. The following year, Lech Walesa and the Solidarity Movement were swept into power, becoming the first democratic government in the region since 1948. In May 1989, Hungary's government dismantled the country's western border, an act that allowed 900 East Germans vacationing in Hungary to simply walk to the west. That summer, thousands of protesters from Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania joined hands to form a human chain across the three countries, singing national folk songs as a symbol of defiance against Soviet internationalism imposed on their countries for decades. All across the Soviet bloc, truths long suppressed by communist police states were being voiced everywhere by people intent on regaining their independence and liberty. On November 9th, as thousands of Germans were continuing to flee across the Iron Curtain in Hungary and elsewhere, the East German authorities announced the opening of a crossing point along the Berlin Wall. Within hours, tens of thousands of people began dismantling the reviled symbol of communist oppression. As a result of growing pro-democracy protests in Bulgaria, recently installed communist leader Petar Malinov appeared on national television in December to announce that the Communist Party was abandoning power and opening up the government. A few months later, Hungary's newly elected Prime Minister Jozef Antal made the historic proposal for the dissolution of the Warsaw Pact, which for decades had been the Soviet counterbalance to NATO. Soviet troops began their withdrawal from Hungary in June 1990. Other countries followed suit, and in July 1991, the Warsaw Pact dissolved altogether. Other countries in the region were not as fortunate and endured violent clashes with communist secret police, as was the case in Romania. Or open war among the countries of the former Yugoslavia. Ordinarily, in a long historical perspective, 2.5 decades are considered but a moment in time. 1989 brought cataclysmic changes to the political landscape of Europe, the dissolution of the Soviet Union, and the collapse of communism in the region. It also revealed that many communist officials had lost confidence in their own failed system of government. The collapse of communism in Europe and the dismantling of the Berlin Wall was the result of many things. That euphoric event required the sustained political will of the free world to confront and contain Soviet imperial ambitions. Most of all, it took the irrepressible human desire for freedom and the courage to fight for it among the peoples of Central and Eastern Europe. The year 1989 saw the triumph of liberty over tyranny in Europe, an event many believed would never happen in their lifetime. The crumbling of the Iron Curtain 25 years ago proved that freedom is not only a dream made true for some, but a hope available to all. The Cold War may be over, but the battle on behalf of those seeking liberty is still being waged every day. Communism still exists in several countries. We know that we must remain vigilant, as freedom and democracy are not given freely, but something that must be fought for and protected.